South Dakota has recreational horse trails all over the state and a lot of organized events for horse and mule enthusiasts. But there's one trail ride that's unlike any other. It's always held on a Sunday in September, and as SDPB's Brian Gevick explains, it's always done for the same good reason.
Imagine riding horseback on a beautiful mid-September day. It's not quite fall, but it's not summer either. You're in hilly Missouri River Bluff country with an oak forest on one side and the expanse of Lewis and Clark Lake below you on the other. It's a good time if you like this kind of thing, but there's something else to feel good about here. The central purpose of the ride is to raise money for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Their focus is on finding cures to the worst childhood diseases. Entertainer Danny Thomas founded St. Jude back in 1962. Since then, researchers have been particularly successful in their fight against acute lymphoblastic leukemia, or ALL.
At that time, the worst childhood cancer is ALL. And at that time, the cure rate was 4%. And now it's up to 94%. So they supply their knowledge for treatment with all hospitals, all children's hospitals.
Cook also appreciates the fact that St. Jude's doesn't turn away any child in need of help.
No family is ever charged for the treatment. That's why it's so important for, people like us and the people that helped me raise money for St. Jude.
Cook says that 100% of the money raised by the ride goes directly to St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. St. Jude dedicates 81% of that amount to research and treatment programs. St. Jude's provides organizational support for saddle-up fundraising events around the country, including another one held at the same time of year in western South Dakota in the Black Hills. But this southeast South Dakota St. Jude ride started in 1997.
My four kids were in a horse club in Yankton. And one of the other leaders had done it once or twice, and she asked me if I wanted to take over. And I thought, well, how hard could it be? So I said, sure. And the first year was kind of a little mini disaster. I guess I thought everybody was going to bring their own food, and pretty much everybody did, but nobody had a barbecue. One of the ladies had to run home and get her little portable barbecue grill. But it came off, you know, we got it done.
Cook has had help along the way from a number of people, including longtime supporter and trail boss, Don Simpson.
He's been really involved till this year. He's in his 80s now, so he turned over the reins to other trail bosses. He was always our trail boss up till last year.
Doug Koth is the trail boss on the 2012 ride. What's a trail boss do?
We're responsible for the route of the trail, where we're going to take our out venture and our return trip from. Responsible for the riders to make sure if they need any help or support that we give them help and support on the trail. You just want to be observant of the mix of horses and people. You know, you have a lot of experienced riders and experienced horses, and contrary, you have inexperienced riders and horses as well. So trying to watch the mix and see how people are getting along, and if they need some support or help, give it to them.
One thing not in the mix on the saddle up for St. Jude ride is alcohol.
You should have control of your horse, and it's kind of hard to do when you can't even hang on to the saddle horn. So yeah, that's one of our laws. No alcohol and no stallions. That's a little risky too.
Most of the ride is in Lewis and Clark State Park, but the start and end pass through private land. That means saddle up for St. Jude riders get a chance to see some trails that most folks don't.
Absolutely, and some of the land we cross, you know, there's no vehicle traffic or anything across there, you know. Probably nothing's crossed those pastures, some of those pastures, except for deer, you know, for the last 12 months.
The length of the trail route varies a little bit from year to year, but in terms of how long riders are on the trail, it usually amounts to about 5 hours, maybe a little more. The ride moves at a leisurely pace. Sometimes adjustments are needed along the way.
What are you doing?
Taking off my saddle, because it's too small for me. We're going to ride bareback.
It's no problem. There's enough help on the trail, and somebody will make sure the saddle makes it home.
Oh, I've never done that before.
rest stop at the State Park Horse Camp marks the halfway point. The park has enough trails that riders won't have to return on exactly the same path.
Well, there are a groomed trail, beautiful scenery. You get to see the lake, you know, the Missouri River, I should say. And some places you can even get down into the, depending on the water level. Last year, I don't think anybody got close to it. But I'm sure this year there was a lot of beach that they'll be able to get down to. And it's just a beautiful sight. It's peaceful, well-groomed.
At about 6:30 in the evening, the ride ends where it started, at the Lewis and Clark Boy Scout Camp. Kyle Robertson lives less than an hour away and likes the fact that he doesn't have to go far for some good riding, but the other reason for the ride really matters.
It's just a great event to help raise awareness and funds for St. Jude so a lot of kids can be helped by it.
We've come for many years. It's a great ride, beautiful scenery, nice companions. It's always nice weather,
and it's a good cause.
Absolutely a good cause.
Good cause.
At supper in the Scouts' dining hall, Muriel Cook, family and friends lay out the food. They help get the door prizes ready. Area businesses have been very generous on that score. Val Heavily has been helping out for years, and so have many people.
You're going to see people that grab a broom afterwards. Doesn't matter if I've asked. They all pitch in and help clean up. And it's, you know, it just reaffirms, you know, that South Dakota's great. We got good people here.
If you'd like to find a Saddle Up for St. Jude ride closer to where you live, well, you probably can. Rides are held all around the country, including western South Dakota. For more information, follow the links on our webpage at sdpb.org/DakotaLife.